Millions of Americans are gearing up for Easter during this Holy Week and will pack into churches on Sunday. But for what? Would so many Christians still be willing to follow the straight and narrow if the consequences of hell weren't hanging over their heads? What if there is no hell? That's the controversial question asked in a new book by popular evangelical pastor Rob Bell. He has suggested to his 7,000 congregants, that's the word I'm going to go with, that there is no pit of fire or eternal damnation. In short, there's no hell. Now, of course, some religious leaders are calling for his exit. And it's the topic featured on the cover of Time magazine. What if there is no hell? Nancy Gibbs is the executive editor of Time magazine. This has really sparked an incredible conversation over what we believe, why we believe it, and all in all, are we just living a good life for nothing if there's not going to be any bad consequences?
Well, I think you could argue that if the only reason you're living a good life is because of fear out of what will happen if you don't, as opposed to wanting to, if you're an evangelical, follow in Jesus' footsteps, then you're already you have a little problem with the risk and reward calculation.
What kind of arguments are you seeing? I mean, this is pretty shocking for a Protestant evangelical preacher to come forward and say, you know what, a God of love does not send people to a hellfire and brimstone, devil-bearing pitchfork place.
You know, if a liberal Protestant clergyman had written this, I think, you know, a couple of bloggers would have posted on it and it would have disappeared. It's exactly because this came from a very popular evangelical preacher who's running a big mega church that it has caused the furor that it has. You know, Rob Bell doesn't really say that there is no hell, but because he redefines what hell is, people are saying, well, that's just as good as denying that there is any such
thing. And how does he redefine it?
Well, he almost equates it with evil. I mean, he says we can't live in the world that we live in and see the kind of evil that goes on and believe that there is no such thing as hell. But hell is something that is present and that we see around us. And he also is suggesting that our notion of heaven, we need to think about heaven as something that is as much here and now, not some distant, faraway place. He's throwing open a lot of questions about whether the image that has been created of a heaven with clouds and harps and a hell with, you know, devils and fire.
And look, I went on to, I mean, you know, there's all these religious websites that you can go to that answer this question based on the Bible. But the interesting thing is, one rabbi I was reading online says, wait, they have totally misinterpreted the Bible. The original Hebrew word in the scriptures, which is sheol, it doesn't mean hell, it means the unknown. So he's saying everybody's basing their belief on physical punishment of fire. That's not the case.
Well, what Bell is arguing for is that, you know, no one has any videotape of what happens after we die. So let's at least admit that
we
don't know, and that this is a mystery, and that scripture itself can be read to suggest a lot of different understandings of hell. As much as anything, he's saying, let's be asking these questions. It's okay. It's not bad to be confused. It's not bad to accept mystery. And yet even that idea for a lot of Orthodox Christians is very troubling.
You know, it'll be interesting to see how many men or women of the cloth this coming Sunday on Easter feel compelled to take up this issue of whether there's a hell. And if there's not a hell, does that mean there's no heaven? But that's, I guess, a topic for another Time magazine article. Thank you so much for joining us. Appreciate your time today.
Thank you.